G'day, Auntie Mahara here. And I just wanted to make this video to talk a little bit about when you're targeted by a narcissist, how uncomfortable that can be on different levels for different people, how stressful that can be, and how impacting that can be, especially if it's an interpersonal relationship, especially if it's, like your partner and you have children together, for example. But the one thing that's really important to remember always is that though you be targeted, you are going to be targeted only to be discarded. And it could be cyclical. It could be like in the case of a husband and a wife where one or the other has BPD or comorbid BPD, NPD or NPD, that it's going to be cyclical targeting. It could happen many times a day. It could happen every day or every other day or three times a week or six times a week. The point is, so these aren't always just, sometimes in some people's circumstances and lives, they're hoping, oh, okay, so I've been targeted by a narcissist and then the discard comes. Whew, okay. Now I can just kind of, recoup and never mind that and whatever. Problem is this, okay? So there's two things to remember in this. One, it can be very cyclical and ongoing. The gaslighting, the emotional blackmail, the fear obligation guilt, the control, the targeting, and all the various other tactics and strategies and ways they abuse, right? And really impact and or traumatize people. That's going to be there. And then it might be your first time. Maybe you know it well. Maybe you're handling it well. But whatever the case is, that's always the setup, the big provocation to be, whether you react to it or not, to being discarded. And then if you make any statement or boundary making statement about, kind of like I'm done or had enough of this or, even in the cyclical type of situations, let alone in others, then you'll feel the discard, if it's an ongoing relationship, and they'll still come back and it'll go around and around and it'll be impacting and wearing you down and hurting more every time. But even with a narcissist, maybe not so close to us, who targets us to abuse us, to gaslight, to get supply, to, for all those, really sick, sadistic often reasons, right, of what they need, what they want, what's folly to them, what fills them up, what makes them feel like kings of little universes or something, then they're just setting us up for the discard. And when the discard comes, okay, we can still bite a hook or two sometimes, right? And it's like, oh boy, But when the discard comes, there's relief, and yet don't ever underestimate the fact that they're never quite really ever done, a lot of them. Sometimes you might encounter a narcissist you've been targeted by, and eventually the cycle goes around and they discard and they move on to the next, quote, victim, unquote, right? Because we don't want to think of yourself as a victim forever. But yes, they victimize people without care, concern, or whatever. No empathy. But the thing is, they also often hoover back. So hoover isn't just a term for people with borderline personality who might contact back for a wholly different reason, by the way. Not the same as narcissists at all. The narcissist is just going to want to come back to see if they can get your goat again. And sometimes, don't we? I mean, I recently did too. I basically did okay with a narcissist targeting me. And then sort of like set a boundary and a limit. And then they still play around, And then I got the most gaslighting communication from this person. And responded to it and then went, oh God, mistake, okay? But we just need to keep learning. We just need to keep growing. So I just wanted to underscore the message today that the narcissist And the abuse and the gaslighting and the provocation and the projecting and the twisting reality and the whole, you know, nonsense they're going to put on you in whatever type of relationship or just kind of like online thing, for example, as it was, may always be with me with this narcissist. The thing is that we have to remember that they don't really ever get enough. That they might be pleased with themselves for a while upon discard or in a cyclical discarding type thing in an ongoing marriage or relationship. But it never really ends. I mean, sometimes they move on and it kind of can end and it's over. But we have to really never underestimate that when they gaslight again after they've discarded, as they're discarding, and then they usually make a discarding state, or not usually, but they can make their discard can be like just ghosting, gone. Or it can be this nice, like little sort of restating, reframing the gaslighting, right? What was really the truth? Like, don't know why you would have ever felt this way, or how could you feel that way, or... And the message they're trying to give you is, what the hell's wrong with you anyway? Because, like, it was all about you in the first place. It was your problem anyhow. And so we have to remember that every time that comes around, or every time you experience that feeling, or whether you've replied to it or not, depending on your situation, and then you feel like the narcissist won again, just remember how hollow and empty their victory is. How short-lived it is, how that charge of supply and whatever it is they sense inside, don't really feel like we feel emotions, how short-lived that will be. And so we at least have to know that any victory on their part is a really hollow one, even if it's like cyclical, like I said. Because that's the other thing I don't think enough people talk about, you know. Narcissists, if you're married to one, or, you know, you're in a long-term relationship with one, they don't always just, like, go away. They don't, when they discard, they just go to another part of your house and maybe do some really other gaslighting things to provoke you in the meantime. And narcissistic abuse, especially from those with narcissistic personality disorder and beyond, it's very sadistic. They very much enjoy, you know, the more that they can hurt us if we ever show them they hurt us or if we are hurt by them. I mean, because comes a time where one can be more desensitized, but that doesn't mean it doesn't still hurt a bit. Because let's face it, these people are outlandish with their entitlement, outlandish with their grandiosity, and with how they treat us in the first place. And so none of that's okay. But they don't get it, and they don't care to get it. So we have to just be kind to ourselves, but never underestimate the cycles of these things, never underestimate how they'll gaslight after they've targeted you, after a discard, if there's any communication. They will then gaslight again, which is what? Really the beginning of the next cycle, whether it takes a day, a week, a month, a year, 5 years to play out, it's going to play out again, chances are. So what we have to really be able to do for ourselves, what you really need to be able to do for yourself, is recognize all this, be mindful as you can about it, and if you make a mistake in it somewhere, you know, like the discards happen and you reply, and then they go ghosting off, silent, you know, until they come back to target again in a cyclical way. Forgive yourself and try to learn. And don't be hard on yourself. And never underestimate the sadistic nature of this abuse. And these strategies and tactics they use just to fill themselves up. Or just to toy with us. Or, you know, whatever it is they want or need on a certain day. To just escape their own inner reality. Which is kind of like an inner hell in many ways. So it's really important to not underestimate the gaslighting and to stay on top of being able to parse that out for yourself and not doubt yourself. And then if you bit a hook after that and then they ghost off and go away, and it's unresolved or it's not resolved. It's never going to get resolved with them. So you have to be really kind and gentle with yourself and know you're learning and growing. And guess what? The narcissist is maybe getting more cunning. The narcissist is maybe getting more controlling. The narcissist may feel like he's building or she's building themselves up to be like even whatever they think. But that's delusional on their part. So, you know, people like myself who's just been through this recently, and you who may be still going through it or have been through it before or more than once, especially if you're an adult child, unfortunately, the point is we're growing, we're feeling, we're processing our emotions, we're with reality, and they're not. And that's why they have to keep trying to get us to doubt our reality. So please don't doubt your reality today. Know your reality. Know when you've been played again. Know when the cycles come around again. And remember, a narcissist that targets you is always targeting to the end, you know, to the end game, though the end may be temporary, but to the end game of discarding you. Because the more that, and then they just ghost, as they call it. They take off silent treatment, or they're gone, right? Until they come back again. Well, and that is a crazy-making aspect of it. But remember, only if you let it be for yourself. So it's really important to be kind to yourself, take good care of yourself, be aware of this, and allow your emotions to come out. Process it emotionally so you can let it go. And just really start to build up the strength and empowerment of, oh yeah, that again. And not having it go any deeper inside yourself. Now that's harder when you're in a relationship, or if it's your husband or wife, and you have children that you're raising, and things, stakes are higher, and it's you know, so all levels of difficulty with this acknowledged, yes, and validated, and want to give you empathy and compassion for wherever you might be. But just know the targeting narcissist, the end game is always discard, and it could be daily, it could be multiple times a day, it could be weekly, in a cyclical way, in ongoing relationships. And it could have years in between in other situations. But as I've just seen the narcissist that was targeting me right now go into a sort of discard phase, I'm sure there's something else coming. I don't think it's over. But by the same token, I want to be aware of that, but I'm not going to worry about it. I'm not going to let it dominate my thoughts or my feelings or my life. Because we have to focus on our lives. We have to focus on ourselves when dealing with these people. And we have to not give them that power. Because when they feel they have that power, that's where they take the most sadistic delight. So don't give them that power. Don't give them that space in your head. Just let it go. And it might sound possible if this is your first time. You're going through this for the first time. Or you have to go through this for an elongated time. But please just know it's possible to build up that kind of self-empowerment to go, oh, okay. And in my case, I'm doing that right now. It's like, oh, okay, well, they're off. That person goes again. And what next? Who knows? Whatever. Like, flow with it. Just leave it alone. And just disengage it. Let it go. And whatever, whatever, whatever. Okay? Empower yourself. And don't be on their bandwagon. Don't be like, you know, having false hope or worrying about what they're going to do. They're really not that powerful. You know, their need to do this to people like you and me means they're really not that powerful in the first place. And nor are their smear campaigns, and they'll out themselves every time. So just be really aware about gaslighting. Be really aware about these discards, you know, they're gaslighting, yes, but the targeting of a narcissist is always with the end game of a discard. But the end game is never the end. In most cases. It may be in some, but in many, it's not. But so, keep your focus on you, keep your focus on your wellness, keep your focus on moving forward, keep your focus on feeling the, embracing the sort of blessing of the lessons, not the situation or the narcissist, but the continued growth that you get, emotionally, intellectually, emotionally, and spiritually. Because you know what? The narcissist will never have what you have. And that's what drives them crazy. So don't let them drive you crazy.